Hey, my name's Zac Watson, and I'm a travel and adventure photographer from Sydney, Australia. Today, I'm gonna walk you through my top 5 travel photography editing tips inside of Lightroom for mobile. So without further ado, let's dive straight in. All right, tip number 1 is to correct your white balance before you do anything else. And the reason why you should always correct your white balance before you do anything else is because you want to make sure you understand what colors you're working with in your shot. So how do you do this? Well, I've got a photo here loaded up inside of Lightroom and I'm in the color tab. As soon as you open up the color tab, you're greeted with the temperature controls right here. And there are 3 main ways to do this. You can use the auto setting, you can use the dropper, and then you can also do it manually. So let me walk you through all 3. I would say this shot has somewhat of an accurate white balance, but let's see what Lightroom thinks is the accurate white balance. If I come to the little as shot drop-down menu here and tap this little arrow, I can press auto and Lightroom will automatically change the white balance settings to what it thinks is correct. Now this looks good. It might be a little bit warm. So let's change this back to as shot and then let's try the dropper setting. I'm gonna come over to the right-hand side here and then this is going to allow me to choose a spot on the image that should be pure white or pure gray. As you can see, that blue should definitely not be white or gray. But I'm gonna select this cloud right here and then I can hit the tick and it's going to slightly adjust my white balance once again. Of course, depending on how accurate or inaccurate your white balance is to start with, but I would say right now things are looking fairly good. Maybe a little bit too warm, so if I wanted to move it manually, all I've gotta do is come down to the temperature setting here and then just back this off a little bit. And I would say things are now looking good. I can now start my edit and understand exactly what colors I'll be working with in my shot. All right, now moving on to one of the most powerful tools inside of Lightroom for mobile, of course, we're talking about the tone curve. I'm about to show you exactly how I personally use the tone curve in about 90% of my shots, and it's super easy and super straightforward. So I've got this shot here, and I'm gonna open up the light tab and then enter the curve. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna place 3 points, and these 3 points represent the shadows, the midtones, and the highlights. So we've got the shadows at this cross section here, we've got the midtones at this cross section here, and then we've got the highlights at that cross section there. There are also 2 other dots that were already preloaded onto this tone curve, and they are the blacks down here and then the whites up here. So how do I use it? Well, the idea here is I like to add a lot of contrast and punch into my work, and that's exactly how I'm gonna use the tone curve. So first on the chopping block, I'm going to drop the shadows, and as you can see, that makes things already quite punchy, but then I'm gonna come to my midtone dot, and I'm gonna increase my midtones, and then I'm also going to increase my highlights. You may or may not already be familiar with the term S-curve, but this is your bread and butter S-curve. From here, I also like to increase the blacks a little bit and decrease the whites a little bit. This helps fade out the darker parts and the brighter parts of the image. That's just a personal stylistic choice, but that is something I will do on about 90% of my shots. When I'm using a pretty basic S-curve just like this one, I find that it really just helps the image come to life and it just adds a whole lot of pop and contrast, which I love. All right, the color grading tool. It's where you can push and pull certain colors into different parts of the image, and you can really start to dial in the looks that you want into your shots in this tool. So let me show you how I use it. First things first, let's open up the color tab and then open up grading. Now here we've got the shadows, midtones, highlights, and global color wheels. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna select a color, push it into that part of the image, and we're gonna do that for all 4 circles, and we're gonna have a look at how it looked before and after. So let's start off with the shadows. I'm gonna add a bit of blue into the shadows as we've got a really clear contrast with warm tones being in the highlights and blue tones being in the shadows, and I wanna lean into that, okay? So all I'm gonna do is grab the middle of the circle and then start moving it around and see where I like the hue to go. So I'm pretty happy with that blue tone right there. And then I'm gonna come down here. If this isn't open for you, you might have to tap this little drop-down menu, and then I'm just gonna back the saturation off a little bit, and I'm happy with that. Now over to the midtones, where we might wanna add some orange, or we might wanna add some blue into our shot. I'm actually gonna lean into the blue tone on this. Once again, just dialing that back just a little bit. I'm only after small changes in the color grading wheels. That's just my personal style and taste. And then we can move over to the highlights, where we are definitely wanting a warmer tone in the highlights. I actually like how much orange we just pushed into the highlights here, so I don't think I'll be dialing back the saturation all that much. If anything, I might actually increase it. I'd say things are looking pretty tasty here. And then over to the global color wheel, which once again, I'm just gonna circle through like this. I actually might leave this as is, maybe a little bit on the orange side. We're gonna dial this right back though. All right, maybe we don't need all that much in the global color space, but I just wanna add a little bit of orange in there. So while these changes may have seemed subtle, let's have a look at a before and after. I'm gonna click done in the top right corner and then come to our versions tab here. And then I can go between this one and this one. And this is the only change I've made on this photo today. And I would have to say things are looking far tastier and I much prefer the color palette on the edited version. All right, now moving on to my absolute favorite part of Lightroom for mobile, we're talking about masking. When you're traveling, it's hard to always shoot with perfect lighting conditions, and that's where I find the masking tab really comes into play. Let's take this photo here, for example. We've got my friend standing in a rice terrace, but he doesn't really pop from the image. So how can we do that? The photo's been edited except for the masks. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna open up our masking tab in the bottom corner. And the idea here, at least my idea here, when I think about masking, is to make the parts of the image around my subject darker, and that will help them stand out. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So I'm gonna take this shot here, and the first thing I do is add a radial gradient. I draw it around my subject. And the reason I don't just use a vignette is because I can customize it. If I wanted it like this, I could. If I wanted it like this, I could as well, which might stretch this out a little bit more. I'm happy with that. I then hit the invert button down to light and then drop the exposure. If I tap and hold on the masking section here and hit hide, you can see how much of an impact that this one mask made. And you can see all of the distractions around my subject kind of get muted down a little bit. So I'm gonna turn this mask back on. I'm gonna hit show and then I'm gonna add another mask. And this time it's a linear gradient coming up from the bottom. I was kind of sunken in the rice terrace when I took this shot. So that means the rice closer to my lens was naturally dark. So I want to lean into that. So I'm going to open up my exposure tab here and then just drop the exposure of that as well, quite drastically. And then I'm going to hit the tick in the bottom corner, open up the masking tab once again, and then we can hide and unhide that mask and see how much of an impact that has had. And simply just by adding these two masks, you can make your subject stand out far more from the image. Of course, you can do so much more with the masking tools. However, this is one of my favorite ways to use them, especially on my travel photos. All right, moving on to the final tip for this video, and that is to use the lens blur feature. This feature is incredible, and I use it especially on photos that were taken on my phone because it helps my subject stand out from the image and blur out the background. Let me show you how I do it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open up the blur tool and then I'm simply just gonna increase the blur amount. Now it might take a little bit of time for Lightroom to understand exactly where your subject is, but let it do its thing because believe me, it's magic. All right, so now that Lightroom has finished analyzing this photo, we can adjust this slider until our heart is content. If I crank this slider all the way up, you can see in the background of this photo, that background is completely blurry, creamy as. And if I just tap and hold on the image to show a before, you can see how much of that background's in focus. And then when I release, you can see how blurry and how professionally nice this looks. My goodness, I love this feature. Now, I'm not gonna crank it this far. I'm just gonna dial it back to a realistic standard. I would say that is looking pretty good there. A quick before and after. And I'm pretty happy. All right, guys, that is gonna wrap up today's video. I hope you were able to pick up a handful of tips and tricks that you can use the next time you're editing inside of Lightroom for mobile. If you did, let me know what they were in the comments down below, and thanks for watching.